And we're now in Synapse Studio. Now, at this moment, we have a fully functional workspace that I can do all the activities in, okay? I can use SQL, I can use Spark, I can use both dedicated SQL pools as well as serverless SQL pools. I can use notebooks, I can use T-SQL scripts, I can look at the docs, I can use the samples, I can create pipelines and schedule them to run, I can monitor the system. All these things are possible just for me now as I've created this workspace. So first of all, you can see it says Synapse Analytics here, and the name of the workspace is up here. Now, you can switch workspaces by clicking up here under Switch Workspace, and I can go to other workspaces from other subscriptions, etc. I won't do that for right now. It's useful to know you don't have to go back into the Azure portal to do this. You can just go here and do it. And of course, you see me, okay? Now, at the top, there's some other things you should be aware of. Number one is there are release notes and updates that come here in this little icon, right? And I'll just close that. And of course, if you want to give feedback, you can click on this feedback icon and you can send us general feedback. Or if you have a feature suggestion, go here and this will take you to our user voice. And you can actually tell us, you know, what you're interested in. And that's great because then people can vote on your feature suggestion. Okay. And that's really all that's important right now. There's going to be a bell icon. So occasionally if I'm doing things in the studio and the system needs to tell me something, you'll see this kind of light up. Okay. So that's what's at the top. Now let's look at what's on the left. So you see these icons and I'm going to expand this out. So these icons we call hubs, and let's look at the first one. This is, we call this the home hub, or actually its formal name is the home page, and it's this area right here, okay? There's a data hub, which is about where you can see the data that's in the workspace or data you've linked, like in a storage account. There's a develop hub where you'll write code. Integrate is where you do data integration, and that means doing pipelines and, you know, authoring them and writing pipeline activities like data flows, etc. Monitor is where you'll see what's going on the system, and then manage is how you configure the system, right? And we'll visit some of those as we start using this. Now we want to drill into something that's a great resource that will really accelerate your ability to use Synapse, especially when you're new to it. But it'll also help you, even if you're a more advanced user. And that's something called the Knowledge Center. And the Knowledge Center contains sample code and sample data and templates that are really going to help you. And the Knowledge Center can be found in Studio a couple of ways. If you're in the home page, you can always just click Learn and get there. So I'll go ahead and do that now. And there you go. I'm now at the Knowledge Center. Okay. And I can go back to home or navigate elsewhere. Now, if I'm not at home, let's say I'm in Integrate, right? I don't see that Learn card, this card here, Learn, right? I don't see it. So I can't get to the Knowledge Center. But there's all, you can always get there by going to the question mark up here. And in fact, it's the first link underneath the question mark, Knowledge Center. Now it'll take you there. Okay, so now that we're here, let's try to understand what's inside. Now we're going to start with Browse Gallery. Okay, now the gallery is open. And by the way, in case you're having trouble figuring out how you get out of the gallery, there's a close button at the bottom right. The gallery contains four kinds of things. And in the future, it'll contain more, but here's what we have now. We have data sets. So if your primary interest is, you know, I want to see what data sets there are, then you'll go here. And we can explore that in a bit. But let me just show you how you can find one. Let's suppose I'm concerned about taxis. Like I'll type in the word taxi. And you can see we have several kinds of taxi data. We have this kind of data, which is for hire vehicles. We have green taxi, we have yellow taxi. These are very popular data sets we use in Spark. So we've made it convenient to get to these data sets. And the data sets are stored actually in Azure Open Data Sets. But when you click, you'll get them inside the workspace. We'll cover that later. I just want to show you how you can find data sets. And then there are notebooks. And so the notebooks here will demonstrate key features of notebooks. So for example, we have the charting one here, right? Which is just how to use a notebook to make kind of interesting visuals. However, a lot of them are more technical. So for example, you know, how do you create a table using, and we have several variations of this. If you want to create a table, what we call an unmanaged table, because the data is going to be in the Azure Data Lake Storage Gen 2 account, we have the sample available as, you know, you can see they have the same name, but the sample, this version of it is PySpark, this is Scala, this is Spark.net, and this is Spark SQL, right? And there's a tons of samples. So this is, when your focus is not the data, but you think more about, you know, right, what the kind of code you want to do or the task you want to do, you go to notebooks or you go to SQL scripts. And there's a bunch of SQL scripts here. And some of these will teach you, you know, some really advanced techniques, like how to use dynamic data masking, for example, right? And again, you can search for all these things here. And over time, we add to this list of gallery items. So, you know, check back here often, and please let us know if you have things you'd like to add. And then finally, pipeline templates. So this is yet again, you know, another way of getting started quick. Many kinds of templates here. So for example, if you want to get data from BigQuery into Synapse, type in big, and you can see, oh, the second one says BigQuery. So you can, you know, click on here and you'll get a pipeline template. Okay, so that is, I'm going to close the gallery and we'll get back to the Knowledge Center. So that's how we got there. We got through there through Browse Gallery. Now let's take a look at the use samples immediately. Okay, so Browse Gallery has a lot of depth and a lot of breadth, but sometimes you just want to get started really, really fast. Okay, and that's what use samples immediately is about. Okay. So this is a highly curated list of special scenarios. And you can see there are only three of them. And let's talk through what they are. And if you want to get started with Synapse, these are the easiest way of doing so because everything's sort of taken care of for you, right? So the three are explore sample data with Spark, which of course we'll use Spark. Query data with SQL. Now, this is going to use a serverless SQL pool. The one that was called built-in, and you saw that when I originally created the workspace. So you always have this serverless SQL pool available. And then another one, which is a very common task in our world, which is creating an external table with SQL. Now this one, you can use either a serverless SQL pool or a built-in pool, right? And it'll even create the pool if you need, which is great. Okay, now that we know what our three options are, the one I'd recommend everyone to try is the middle one, called Query Data with SQL, because it uses the serverless SQL pool, which right now is the only pool that exists in my workspace. It's the fastest one to get you started, because you have to do nothing. You don't have to create anything in the workspace. So let's click it, and then at the bottom, click Use Sample. Now, all this does, remember, the pool's already available to every workspace, the one called built-in, the serverless SQL pool. So all this sample does is create a SQL script. Now let me create some more space by minimizing some of these windows. And let's take a look at the script, okay? Well, actually, before the script, let's just take a look at what is around the script. So it says, this is the name of the script, Query Data with SQL. And you can, of course, if I click Run, it'll run it. And by the way, if I click, if I select some text and I click run, just that section of this script will run. And of course, publish will save this. You need to pay attention to this one, which is called connect to. So this tells you which pool is being used. I only have one pool, so if I expand this, you can only see the built-in pool. This is the serverless SQL pool. If I want to add or remove pools, I can click here and get to the management UI to do that, but I won't bother doing that right now. And then, of course, there's a default database it's going to be using, and so it's you can set that here. Now, default, it's master, and that's the only one that exists in this in the workspace. We can create other databases that are usable by serverless SQL.